How's it going, everyone? Mickey T here. Welcome back to the channel, and it's time for a review of the new Juice WRLD album, Legends Never Die. Legends Never Die is the posthumous release from the late Juice WRLD, who passed away back in December. When it comes to Juice WRLD's music, I saw that the guy had a lot of talent, especially with his freestyle game and his hook game. One of his more notable moments was the hour-long freestyle that he did on Tim Westwood, and the fact that most of his material is freestyled and how he manages to pump out hit after hit after hit with his freestyle material is fantastic, and it's something that can't really be overlooked. But how does that talent translate to an album setting though? For me, it doesn't really go over all that smoothly. Goodbye and Good Riddance has some of my favorite Juice WRLD tracks on it, yet it has a lot of misses for me, and Death Race for Love was probably one of my least favorite listens from him, mostly because I thought that it had a lot of filler on it, a couple of bad tracks and a lot of mediocre tracks that outweighed the good. That wasn't my only fear going into this album though, as this is a posthumous album. A lot of posthumous albums have been done in bad taste as of late, especially in the rap game. For example, the latest XXXTentacion posthumous album Skins and Bad Vibes Forever were just blatant cash grabs, and to some degree that new Pop Smoke album was a bit of a cash grab, but posthumous albums can be done right. For example, this year we had Mac Miller's Circles, which is one of my favorite records of the year. Looking down at the tracklist for this album though, there are a couple of red flags, one being the length of the tracklist. There are 21 tracks on here, technically 18 since there's interludes, and that leaves me with a sense that there will be filler. Two being some of the features, Marshmello and Halsey are media eye rolls, but there are features here that make sense, like Polo G, The Kid LAROI and Trippie Redd. And three, there isn't really much that can be done with Juice WRLD's sound for the tracklist length. That meaning that Juice's style is a bit inconsistent for an album this long, but I digress. So it's time to answer the question, is this album good? In my opinion, it's a mostly tasteful posthumous album that a fan would definitely enjoy, but for me, it suffers from a lot of the same things that a Juice WRLD project normally suffers from.
Imagine putting your producer tag as the first thing you hear on a posthumous album.
I'll note what I liked first. I like a fair few tracks on here that I can definitely see myself coming back to. Righteous has a great emotional potency to it. The guitars and the beat sound really sweet. It works really well in companion to the trap percussion. Juice WRLD's vocals work very well on here. He gives you what you normally expect from him, except the lyrics on this one are pretty much intentionally foreshadowing. I love his faint vocals and the chorus giving the whole track a haunting feel. Hate the Other Side with Marshmello, Polo G and The Kid LAROI was great as well. The instrumental is more trap focused than I would have expected with Marshmello on the production, so props to him for not fucking this one up. Polo G was alright on here. You get what we normally expect from him, a lot of street tragedy bars, but nothing mind blowing, a bit lacking of energy for me. I've not been the biggest fan of Polo G to begin with, so I was kind of expecting this, but The Kid LAROI stole the show for me. I like his impassioned vocals, his flow is very catchy, he added a ton of energy to the track that Polo kind of took away. Juice is more of a contributor to the hook, and he delivers one of the best hooks on the project, easily one I can see myself returning to. Life's a Mess was one of the singles released prior to the album's release, and it still remains one of my favorite singles from the project. Easily one of the best performances from Juice WRLD on here. I love the hook. I love his verses. He had some solid lines in there. Halsey is barely on the track, so that's a good thing. And the beat is absolutely fantastic. The haunting background vocals are great. The melody sounds nice. I love the emotion and the beauty of it too. Makes for one of the more beautiful cuts in the album. Wishing Well has one of his more impassioned performances. I love his vocals on here. It fits the piano-based trap instrumental. It's a real sad boy anthem. The lyrics are depressing and I absolutely love it. Stay High is a high like for me. His vocals sound pretty Post Malone-esque on here, but I like the low-key atmospheric instrumental. Juice's flow is the catchiest on this track in particular. The hook is solid. The second verse is pretty dark. He has some pretty great lines on here too. And finally, Can't Die is a great highlight for me as well. The synthetic orchestral melody sounds really cool. The lyrics are pretty reflective of all the people that Juice has lost in the past. And of course, there's some foreshadowing here as well. And it takes a very strong approach to this kind of songwriting for Juice. And it makes for a very strong track on here. Like, I also have to mention that a lot of the choices on here are pretty tasteful for Juice WRLD standards, as it was definitely something that sounded like Juice WRLD could have actually made if he was still alive today. Maybe a couple of tracks here just don't fit at all, but I'll get to them later on. But all in all, this whole experience does seem very tasteful and actually comes from a place of care for me. The rest of the album has its fair share of issues though. The tracks that I don't really care for all that much either had some pretty samey instrumentals. For example, a lot of them will have a signature Nick Mira guitar melody on top of some trap percussion, and that isn't too bad, but it seems like there just wasn't much detail put into a lot of it on that end. I just couldn't stand a lot of the mixing on here. Sometimes you'll get melodies you can barely hear in the beat, the percussion may just be mixed way too loud like on Screw Juice, or there can be moments where the beat just feels flat as hell and flaccid because the percussion is just mixed so damn quiet like Titanic and Bad Energy. Some of Juice WRLD's performances don't do much for me a lot of the time. They come off as more or less the same as what Juice WRLD would normally do, but they seem more forgettable. But these tracks that I don't care for seem fairly decent because of either the production or Juice's performances, and that's something. Sometimes they just kind of rub off each other the wrong way, if you make that comparison. There are tracks on here that just don't sit right with me though, either because they just don't fit on this album or they just straight up sound awful and an absolute disgrace. Take the track Come and Go with Marshmallow. The EDM production on that song is just so corny and it sounds terrible. Sounded like it would have been decent at first, but then those fucking claps and the guitars came in and I just got so mad because of how generic and forced it sounded. Not to mention, it just sounds formulaic. And if you haven't noticed already, I think Marshmallow's music is absolute trash. Tell Me You Love Me is also a moment on the album that just makes me want to turn it off the instant it comes on because the beat is terrible. I hate how the bass is mixed, the melody sucks, and it frankly ruins the song. Trippie's hook is one of the most bland on this project, really one of the most bland from Trippie period. It's even more bland than a majority of the hooks on exclamation mark. And Juice was the only real redeeming quality of this track. The track Man of the Year seems to be an attempt at doing a crossover pop punk song, and it has an anthemic feel to it, but it just comes off to me as a bit awkward and a little bit corny given how surface level the punk influence is on this track. If more thought and care would have been put into it, then maybe I would have enjoyed it a lot more, but it just doesn't sit right with me. It just doesn't fit on this album in my opinion. Normally I would complain about interludes at times, but I feel like the interludes work on here. The Man, the Myth, the Legend interlude is essentially Juice getting cosigns and props from Eminem, J. Cole, Lil Dicky, and even more. The intro sees Juice touching on his music, anxiety, his substance abuse, and Juice WRLD Speaks From Heaven outro might come off as a bit distasteful at first, but it's more for the fans if anything else, and I can respect that. And that's what most of these interludes are. They are basically for the fans, and they are necessary for Juice as a figure, in my opinion, how influential he was to a lot of people. And it's saddening to see, because the guy had so much potential, and he could have been the biggest artist in the world for all we know, but unfortunately we'll never get to see that happen. So overall, I think Legends Never Die is a good posthumous album, but as a Juice WRLD album it has a lot to be desired. A lot of the choices on here for the most part were pretty tasteful. There were moments on here that just didn't sit right with me. But all in all, this is definitely something that a Juice WRLD fan would get a lot from. For me, I took away a lot of great tracks on here, the ones that I mentioned at the start, and there were plenty of decent to good tracks on here, but a lot of it to me just felt like it was a bit ill-conceived and a bit filler. And that's an issue that plagues Juice WRLD's projects in my opinion. And remember, this is just my opinion at the end of the day. You don't have to take my opinion all that seriously. This is just me throwing thoughts out there because that's what I like doing. I like throwing my opinions out there. And of course, this is all out of respect for the artist, so in all seriousness, rest in peace, Juice WRLD. Thanks so much for checking out my review of the new Juice WRLD album, Legends Never Die. Did you agree with my opinion? If you did, please consider leaving a like. If you disagreed with my opinion, leave a comment down below and we can have a discussion about it as long as it's not toxic. My Swans discography diaries will be up in a few days. Links to the taped podcast will be in the description below. Go follow me on Instagram at MickeyTReviews. Check out my album of the year and rate your music pages as well. And as always, my name's been Mickey T, and thanks for watching.